Let's just go over the basics, okay? I've never done this before. And I know a lot of people have been asking. So, we can do a mage guide. I guess we could start with, like, super basics. Like, talents, glyphs. And then we can move on to stuff more like positioning and rotation later. You guys want to see that? I'm sure you guys do. I know a lot of people have. Frost Mage Guide. Did you just tell Sirius an alarm? No, I didn't. You're fucking awesome, subbing in an hour. Love you. Yes, you guys want to see that? Alright. I know a lot of people have been asking for that. Especially a lot of the subs and stuff, so I will. Defreeze, Ice Lance, block, repeat, win. Oh yeah, definitely. Make it a VOD, I have to go soon. Yeah, I'll make it a VOD. Just got a subscriber. Snowstorm XD, thanks for subbing, man. That's how many subs today? 7 subs today, thanks so much, guys. We got 13 subs yesterday, so we're almost to yesterday's subs. That's insane, guys. Getting so many subs recently. That's 219 subscribers that we're at. Make it a VOD. I will, alright. Welcome, Snowstorm. Okay. Yeah, I actually like this song. I'll play it after this. Alright. I'll start with the super basics, guys. Talents. When you go into arena, this is the spec you're gonna be going with. Pretty much, you know, I'm just gonna turn the music off, actually. When you go into arena, this is the spec you're pretty much gonna be playing with all the time. So you queue up with this. If you're fighting cleaves, if you're fighting like double physical damage, like Hunter Warrior, Hunter Enhance, basically like Hunter Melee, like Hunter Rogue, you don't really see that much of that. You can go Blazing Speed Ice Sword. It depends on what comp you're playing too. So if you're playing MLS, I would suggest staying Presence of Mind against every team. If you're playing Rogue Mage Druid, you can go Blazing Speed Ice Sword against cleaves. Yeah. Either way though, you can go Ice Ward against cleaves, even if you're playing MLS. So if you're playing MLS and you're fighting a cleave, you can go Palm, Ice Ward. Everything else is the same. So Temp Shield always in threes, Cold Snap always threes, Living Bomb always in threes, and Canners. The only thing you're gonna change in threes is either your 15 talent tree or your 45 talent tree. So, yeah. And that's pretty much the only thing you're gonna change. You're never gonna use Frost Draw, you're never gonna use Ice Flows. So, as MLS, you pretty much want to stay Palm all the time, but you can switch between Ice Ward and Ring. Ice Ward against double melee, or double physical damage. And you can use it against Rogue Mage as well. Keep in mind, guys, a lot of it is dependent on the comp you're playing. So, MLS, Palm is really good. RMP, it's good, but it's not as good as running away and resetting. So Blazing Speed is really good for that. So pretty much these are your talents. I mean, that's it. That's pretty much it. Like, everything is like how you see here. Blazing Speed and Ice Ward are the only things you'll change it for, and I mean, basically what I just said is when you change it. Glyphs, these are the ones you're always going to be going in with. Glyphs are actually simple as fuck for Mage. You go into these three. The only time you're going to change a glyph is against double caster. So like Shadow Priest Lock. The LSD is basically the big one you're going to see. MLS, you'll see a lot. You're going to change Ice Block over Armors. You should always keep Poly and you should always keep Deep. There are exceptions, like fighting Rogue Mage Druid, for example, you could switch out Poly with Ice Block if you want. So You just have to let your team know that you don't have Polyglyph so that they don't just randomly dot healer and stuff like that. But yeah, for the most part, the only glyph changing you're gonna do as a mage is Ice Block over Armors. Yeah. But against like any melee team, any like KFC, any cleave, this is what you're gonna be running with. Armors deep poly. Okay. I'll go back to talents for one sec because I kind of skipped over something. Whenever you have a healer, so in RBGs, in threes and twos with a healer and fives, run Temp Shield. Whenever you don't have a healer in a 1v1 situation, in a 1v2, maybe you're queuing Battlegrounds by yourself and you don't trust your healers, you can go Ice Barrier over Temp Shield. Ice Barrier is better if you don't have a healer. Temp Shield is better if you do have a healer. Yeah, that's the only thing I missed. Literally never use Frost Bomb. Living Bomb always in Arena. Nether Tempest is better in RBGs though. So Nether Tempest and RBGs, Living Bomb in Arena. Yeah, that's it. You'll never use Cauterize, you'll never use Greater Invis. Yeah, that's it. Nether Tempest RBGs, Living Bomb Arena. Ice Ward versus Cleaves. Blazing Speed versus Cleaves if you're running RMD. Ice Barrier when you don't have a healer. That's pretty much everything you have to know for talents. Okay. I guess we can look at gear briefly. A lot of people ask why mages don't really run the trinkets anymore, or just why aren't you wearing a trinket? I have it here. I have it to shift one. As a mage, you don't need a trinket because you have Blink. Blink frees you from stuns. If Blink didn't free you from stuns, you'd always have to wear a trinket because you'd be just, you'd be vulnerable. You'd be like a warlock or like a Shadow Priest or something. You can Blink out of stuns. That being said, you can't just randomly blink. You have to save your blink as a trinket. Like you have to blink. If you're prone to die, you have to save blink as an out. So you can't really like blink in offensively. Yeah, or you're just gonna give them a free ice block, or a free whatever your healer cooldown, which sometimes is fine. But yeah, mages don't need trinkets because they have blink and they have ice block. So you pretty much want to be running with Dominance, Insignia, and Badge, I guess is the easiest thing to say. Yeah, you don't need a trinket as a mage because of Blink, and you have Ice Block. So, yeah. That being said, Insignia is only really good like if you actually pay attention to the proc. I'll try to get the proc in a sec, so I can show you guys what it looks like. When Insignia procs, like, you need to do some. Yeah, and someone else said, and Will of Forsaken, that's definitely true. You have Will of Forsaken too. When you're a human, you can just run both of these anyway. What was I just talking about? Okay, yeah, so you have to pay attention to your Insignia proc, for sure. When that procs, you can pop on use, you can maybe Orb and Altar, and it's just like a shit ton of damage. Like, you have to pay attention to this trinket proc all the time in arena. Like so many mages will alter before it procs. It'll proc during their alter, then they'll take their alter back in time and they waste the proc. Like you have to keep an eye on this trinket for when it procs. Other than that, gearing is pretty simple. I mean, I guess I could go over stat priority quickly. Haste, mastery, crit are the three stats in order. So haste first, mastery second, crit last. I guess I should go even before that. Intellect is better than anything. You also want hit cap. So hit cap and intellect, and then for your three stats, you want haste, mastery, and then crit. Trying to think if I forgot anything. I think that's everything. So hit cap, intellect, haste, mastery, crit. There's no like caps or anything. You just want as much haste as you can get because it increases GCD and casting speed. It's not really for more ticks on Living Bomb. It's not really for anything like that. It's literally just so you can Ice Lance quicker and get polys off more efficiently. Yeah, okay. I guess that covers gear. A lot of people ask about professions. And for a mage, it kind of depends. If you're Alliance, you have a built-in trinket. So you do not want to be engineering if you're Alliance. It's terrible. If you're Horde, you have like two options basically. Is this, I don't know, some this might go over some people's heads. But as if you're Horde, you can go engineering. You'll get Glove Enchant, which is an on-use trinket, which means you don't need to use an on-use trinket since you already have it on your gloves. Since you already have it on your gloves, you can replace your on-use trinket with one of these. So you can always have an on-use on your gloves, and you can always wear a trinket, which is really beneficial to always wear a trinket and always have an on-use. The problem with that is you do less damage. You're not as fucking real, so you're not as bursty. You don't have a non-use, like a sick on-use anymore. You have a glove on-use instead of a real on-use. So yeah, that's why I don't go engineering. It's because you don't do as much damage. You're more well-rounded. You can always wear a trinket, but you don't do as much burst as engineering. That's your first option. You can go well-rounded and be an engineer and do less damage, or you cannot be an engineer and not wear a trinket and just put a trinket on against major rogue teams. And yeah, that's pretty much it for professions. I don't know, tailoring. Alright, tailoring's alright. I prefer not being a tailor. And the reason being, your cloak enchant gives you 180 intellect. If you're a tailor, you don't get a cloak enchant anymore, it gets replaced by the tailoring enchant. So you're losing 180 int, and you're losing the 320 ints you would be getting from another profession. So by going tailoring, you're losing 500 passive intellect at all times. Like, you're losing 500 intellect just by choosing the profession. So 500 intellect is not really worth giving up just for the proc, in my opinion, for a mage. It's not bad, but it's not great. So in my opinion, the best professions for a mage is double 320 int for Horde, and Alliance, actually. So whether you're undead or human, that's good. Having said that, like if you're like in a tournament or something and know you're doing RMP mirrors, it's probably good to go engineering just so you can always wear that trinket and always have it on use. But yeah, double 320 int is really fucking good. All right, so that covers professions, gear, glyphs, talents. Okay, I guess we could talk about positioning for a little bit. Man, I should have filled up my water cup before. My mouth is fucking dry from talking for like 15 minutes straight. Positioning is like something that a lot of people struggle with. Let's see. I'll go to I'll go to chat. I'm gonna go into an arena and actually show you guys what I'm talking about. Okay, race. That's a good question. While I'm flying there, I could talk about race. I mean, I guess the simple answer is if you're Horde, go undead, and if you're Alliance, go human. The reasoning behind that. Orc isn't that good because you have blink for stuns already. So this stun reduction is like negligible. Orc isn't bad. Like you're gonna not have will, and will's fucking OP, but you're gonna have more burst. So orc isn't terrible for mages whatsoever. Like orc is definitely a strong second. But Will of Forsaken is really good, and I forgot what it's called, but whatever that static. Touch of the Grave is also really fucking good. People don't know what it is. I'll just leave it up for a second so you can read it. But yeah, simple answer. If you're human, I mean, if you're Alliance, go human. If you're Horde, go undead. You can also go Orc if you want. That's not bad. It's almost just as good. It's just, I don't know. Undead's a little better. Okay. This is Nagrand. So when you're going in, say like your enemies are just like. How do I fight? fucking do this.